The futures triangle is a famous foresight methodology created by future Sohail in Ayatollah that allows us to map the future of any topic before creating scenarios of that topic based on three dimensions: the pushes, the pulls, and the weights, which correspond to three angles of a triangle. Let's take a closer look at the method. The pushes are those driving forces in the present that affect the future, such as technological change. The pulls are visions or images of the future that act as a force of pull of society towards the future, such as utopias. And the weights are those barriers to change that keep us in the past, so to speak, such as cultural traditions. The strength of this very simple mapping method is that it can help us to analyze the conflict between those forces in the present, which are the pushes and the pulls, that bring about change to the future on one hand, and those forces against change, which are the weights, usually ideological and cultural in nature, on the other hand. Yet, unfortunately, this very interesting aspect of conflict in the original method was not well emphasized, nor was it integrated with the practice of scenario planning, which usually follows the analysis done in the futures triangle. So the futures triangle has mostly been used as a brainstorming technique, rather than as a tool to analyze conflict in foresight practice. So in this paper, what I wanted to do is focusing on this aspect of conflict, and I did that by designing a variation of the futures triangle method, which I call the futures triangle 2.0, that can help us integrating this aspect of conflict from the futures triangle with scenario planning, with the help of a very intuitive figure, so that when we create scenarios, each scenario will have a very in-depth discussion of conflict, which is a very important part of foresight practice. I present a case study of the application of this method taken from a workshop I've run in China where I've used this method in practice. If you want to read the paper, click the link down below, and if you don't have access to the journal, just leave a comment and I'll send you a copy of the manuscript. Happy reading!